Hello friends, today we are going to discuss general properties of gases. Before we start to discuss some properties of gases, we must know that in between the molecules of gases, the force of attraction, that is force of cohesion, is weakest and you can say negligible, zero, in between two molecules of the gases. But due to this reason, we have large space in between two molecules of gases. So from this concept, what we observe that we have large intermolecular space and less, or we can say negligible, force of attraction or force of cohesion. For these two factors, molecules of solid try to move away from each other. Means one more, if you keep two molecules here at this place without any force, if you apply force, they come closer. But when we release the force, what happens? It's natural tendency of molecules of gases, they move away from each other. They do not need any type of combination with the physical combination with the molecules, other molecules of the same gases or other gases. That's why they move away from each other. Why they are able to move away from each other? The natural tendency having large intermolecular space. Why we have large intermolecular space in case of gases? Because they have less amount of force of attraction. So I hope this part is clear. Then, as we know that liquid molecules can slip over each other, but they obey the boundary, they obey the volume of the liquid. But in this case, gas molecules, they can flow over each other, they can slip, they can move away from each other, but they are unable to maintain the volume of the gases. A gas takes the volume of the container, as well as shape, size, but also the volume of the container. Both liquid and gas can flow, so they are known as a fluid. That's why they are known as a fluid. F-L-U-I-D. This is the liquid. So this is the clear, because they are able to flow. Now we are going to discuss about the properties. Though I have these two factors, you must remember that less intermolecular force of attraction in case of gases, but large intermolecular space. Less intermolecular force of attraction, large intermolecular space. Now, the first property says that a gas has neither a fixed volume nor a fixed shape. Nor a fixed shape. This is the first condition. It has neither a fixed volume nor a fixed shape. Why these gases have not fixed volume? Because due to less amount of force of attraction, they are not fixed at the at their places. That's why they move away from each other, and that's same for the same reason they have not fixed volume as well as fixed scale. So this, I think this one is clear to you. In this case, molecules are free to move away from each other. Then next point is, gases can be compressed up to a larger extent. More than solid and liquid. Gases can compress more than solid and liquid. Why they can compress? We know that there is a large amount of space in between the molecules. So when we try to compress them, we can compress them easily up to a large extent. That's why we can, because we have, in this case, we have large space. I'm not adding the compliment, I'm adding the giving you only a hint. Large intermolecular space is there in between two molecules, so gases can compress more than solid and liquid. Next part is, gas can expand, that expansion and contraction. As we know that gas molecules are more energetic, when we give them heat, they receive energy and becomes more and more energetic. So they start to move away from each other or move inside the container more vigorously. So when we give heat energy, they try to expand easily in little amount of, by receiving little amount of heat, they expand more. They move away from each other, that is expansion, they expand more. So they can expand more due to the less amount of space, less amount of force of attraction, and large amount of space. Similarly, if we cool them, they start, means what, we decrease their energy level, they become less energetic, so they come closer and closer due to the large availability of large space. They come closer to closer very easily. So that's why they can contract on cooling more than solid and liquid, and then they expand also more than solid and liquid. The next point is, they freely mix with each other. Whatever amount is given, whatever density is given of two or more gases, they can freely mix. Freely mixed with each other means, for example, air. In air we have all types of gases. Why? Because there is a large amount of intermolecular space due to large intermolecular space. There is availability of space for more and more molecule. That is why gas molecules easily mix with the other. They occupy the empty space in the container in between two molecules of same gases. So I think this one is also clear. Our last point is, this is a new point. And what is this? Sorry. Tends to move high to low pressure zone. Suppose, what is this? It is a natural tendency of gas molecules to move away from each other, that you know. But if pressure is high, if we give a force to bring them closer, so we try to decrease this their natural tendency to move away from each other. But as soon as there is availability of low pressure, means we decrease the force, that is the decreasing of pressure, they try to move away from each other. So gas molecules always try to move towards low pressure zone so that they can move away more and more from each other. That is the fifth property, tends to move from high pressure to low pressure zone. These are the today's discussion point. In many books, some experiments are given, some activities are given. You must read the activity very carefully, and then when you read those activities, you must understand easily, because you know the concept of intermolecular space and intermolecular force of attraction in between two molecules of same element or same matter. That's all for today. Next year, we'll discuss some more interesting topic. Thank you.